At Meta.ai, we are comparing the activations of deep learning algorithms to those activations of the brain.
Is mind reading one of the top three superpowers you wish you had? Well, artificial intelligence is starting to tackle that. The technology is nowhere near Professor X level yet, but the results will amaze you. With recent progress in AI, science fiction and the real world seem to be coming together in some parts. At the end of this video, you will no longer think AI-assisted telepathy is such a crazy idea. Decoding speech from brain activity has been a long-standing goal of neuroscientists and clinicians. Brain recordings vary a lot from person to person because of differences in brain anatomy. Other reasons are because of where and when the nerve cells fire in parts of the brain and the location of sensors placed during a recording session. As you can already tell, analyzing brain data generally requires complex scientific methods. The most effective way to keep track of what's going on in the brain is to have electrodes surgically implanted.
Ouch, baby. Very ouch.
These are known as invasive techniques, and they obviously present potential dangers to the patient. It is also very impractical and uncomfortable to use in the everyday lives of patients who may need it. On the other hand, non-invasive methods don't involve surgery. Instead, electrodes are attached to the scalp, or a device-like scanner is placed over the head. The downside of non-invasive methods is that they aren't as accurate as invasive techniques, simply because they aren't directly connected to the brain. There have been previous attempts to understand what a person is thinking, but solutions are very specific to the individual and slow to produce even the simplest of words. Researchers have been looking for more accurate and general applications of this use case, and now it seems we're headed there. Scientists at Facebook AI Research Labs have developed an AI model that can decode speech from non-invasive recordings of brain activity. Despite the noisy data from the technique, the AI model still shows very promising results. The lab aims to help people who have had traumatic brain injuries and are unable to effectively communicate. They trained an AI algorithm to analyze the brain activity of 169 healthy people listening to audiobooks in English and Dutch. Let's peek a bit behind the curtain and analyze what the AI model is about. Participants in the test listen to hours of audiobooks, and their brain activity is captured using MEG or EEG wave formats. MEG and EEG are a type of non-invasive methods that we previously mentioned. These waves are transformed into numbers because that's how computers understand concepts. These numbers are simultaneously matched to the actual words in the audiobooks. Essentially, brain waves are compared to speech waves, and the similarities are identified.
With magneton sophrography, we can identify at every millisecond the brain responses to individual words and individual sentences. So we can track, as a function of time, the brain responses to words. Comparing human brain responses to algorithms trained to process language. We have areas in the brain which are similar to algorithms trained to do perceptual representations. We have areas in the brain which are similar to algorithms which we call word embeddings. And we have a whole network of brain regions which seems to behave similarly to what we call language transformers.
The results from the AI model show that it can decode speech with up to 73% top 10 accuracy. This means that out of a set of 10 possible sentences, the AI model predicts the results with 73% accuracy. I hope that didn't confuse you even more. And 73% might seem like a decent number, but considering how complicated the problem is, that's very, very outstanding. If you have any questions, please leave them in the comment section and I'll answer them. The model was tested on a vocabulary of 793 words, which is mostly what we use in everyday conversation, according to Meta. This is an exciting step because it shows AI can successfully learn to decode noisy and variable, non-invasive recordings from brain activity. This work is part of an effort by the scientific community to use AI to better understand the human brain. Powerful technology, as we know, can be used for both good and bad. The bad part about this technology is that powerful entities like governments may unlawfully use it for intrusive purposes, like spying on citizens or unethical intelligence gathering. At this point, the model doesn't have such capabilities. The authors also say that methods of resistance like clenching your teeth or blinking can mess up the signals and may stop unwanted brain-to-speech decoding. Now that's a little glimmer of hope, at least for now. In addition to Meta, a group at the University of Texas at Austin created an AI model that can also decode speech from non-invasive recordings of the brain. Their techniques involve training the model on three participants using fMRI brain recordings. These recordings were generated from listening to 16 hours of narrative stories. And don't worry, they were split into multiple sessions due to possible fatigue. The authors divided their work into imagined and perceived stimuli. This is because they wanted to investigate the overlaps between imagining a story and either listening to audio or watching a movie. They performed an interesting experiment in which they monitored brain signals while people watched a silent movie. Who doesn't love a silent movie? You can see here that the AI system is still able to generate conceptual meaning of what the brain is processing, even though there are no words in the film. The text produced might not very accurately match the visuals, but when you consider the hundreds of thousands of words and their almost infinite combinations, you can start to see how amazing the results are. This may also be because the brain is able to anticipate quickly what may happen before it happens. And so it filters through future possibilities before the next set of visuals come in. They stated that the technology currently works only if the participant is willing to cooperate. Resistance methods like mental math and imagining a different story seem to lower the effectiveness of decoding speech from brain recordings. Many relationships may be salvaged if only we knew what the other person was thinking. It will save a lot of conflicts and misunderstandings, but the most likely outcome will be the opposite. Everyone has thoughts they want to keep private, or sometimes there are just random thoughts we unconsciously have. Thoughts like these are definitely not what we want other people to know. Just like other topics we've discussed on this channel, AI is starting to get good at predicting even the hardest things, and people are both excited and concerned about its potential influence in our lives. Like most great technologies, engineering advances take huge leaps before policies are even developed to keep up with fast-paced progress. Companies like Neuralink and Kernel are also working hard on brain-computer interfaces that are very accurate and in the future can be used to treat diseases or disorders, connect with digital devices, or keep an eye on a person's overall health. What do you think about mind-reading technology and its potential in, say, 10 years? Maybe if I had a futuristic version of this technology, I would instantly know your answers. But please do leave your thoughts in the comment section below. I'm looking forward to reading them. We also discuss other exciting AI innovations on this channel, so click on the links above for more mind-blowing AI trends. Until the next video, it's goodbye and thank you.